practical use for the hidden series is to interlink two charts. So the way Excel works is if you create a chart here, you'll see it's called small product. Here's one called big product. And because of the size of the numbers, these two, although they look the same size, if you look at the scales, this one goes up to 100, this one goes to 1,000. So if we want these two charts to take note of each other and use a common scale, then we somehow need to tell them both what the smallest and the biggest number is in the entire series, because that's the only way we're going to actually be able to get Excel to scale it correctly. This is short of you manually going in, because you can do this. I can go in here, format axes, and I can specify the maximum here. So I can go and type in 1,000 here. Problem with that is next time anything changes, I'm going to have to come in here and manually do it. So another way to do that is first to create a common series. So you'll see there's my data. And notice I've created a max function. So what I've said is look at the two products and find the maximum number here. And that flows all the way along. Over here then, we've done the same thing, except we've said look at the minimum number. So these two series now are common between the two, and what we can do is, for example, I'm going to take the max and min, I'm going to copy it, I'm going to paste it into small products, and while that's copied, I'm going to paste it into big products. Now, despite the mess of all the colors, notice the scales are the same. So now what we can do is we can actually tell it these two, max and min, we actually don't want to see them. So we're going to hide them. So for example, I'm going to right click on that, format data series, and I'm going to say fill it with no fill. Same thing with this one here. I'm going to say fill it with no fill. So you can see we've made them disappear. Still not ideal because you can see the series is a little bit to the left. Let's just do these. No fill. No fill. So now the axes are the same. Charts look okay, but remember, if we want to now have it appear as if it's coming from the central spot, I just right click on the series, format data series, and for the series overlap, I'm going to say 100%. So you'll see it's now in the middle. Let's just do the same thing here. So now what you have is two charts with a common series that is hidden. So it is actually in here. If you looked for it, you'd find it, but it's not been shown. This way, if something changes, for example, this big product now, let's make it 1016, it changes, but notice because of the way we've created the common series, the axes changes, and you can actually see the comparative between the two products.